Now on YTV, an entertaining hour is in prospect with star guests joining their smiling host, Des O'Connor.
Ladies and gentlemen, Des O'Connor.
Thank you. Good evening to you. Very friendly little crank. It dawns on me here in show three, we're already in show three of the series, that I haven't even hinted at, let alone mentioned, my little baby daughter. Aww. I'm a proud dad, and when it comes to the kids, there's a little bit of Anne Diamond in all of us, isn't there? I'm not the sort that walks around with a fistful of pictures of the baby here. I do not have one picture here. I've got a nice one here. That is Christine. You are... Oh, don't have to go mad. It was my pleasure. She was about 6 months then, and she just turned one now, and she just said her first word. And Jay, my wife, was hoping she'd say Mama. I was hoping she'd say Dada. She said Bananarama. Kids today. She's so cute. Really, really cute. A special treat for tonight. She's watching. We've let her stay up. And I know it's a bit of an indulgence, but do you mind if I just say hello to her? No. Hello, Christina. It's your little daddy. Don't you whittly, whittly in your little gym chat. This could be a hit. Well, she's in her baby bouncer, you see, at home. She's walking now. She's really cute now, really cute. I said to my wife the other day, I said, what do you think she'll be like when she grows up? She said, I often think that about you. I said, she said something very interesting to me. Wouldn't it be nice if she had someone her own age to play with? I said, well, she's got you. She said, I meant a little baby brother. And I thought, well... You mean daughters are fine, but a little... Can you imagine me with a boy in 15 years' time? Dad! We're going to play football. Oh, yes. Where's the post? He'll want to know the facts of life, and I'll be too old to remember. Well, Christine is lovely. She's a lucky baby. Little Christina, I know she's lucky, because when she can't get to sleep at night, when she's crying, I have a wonderful way of getting her off to sleep. I sing. Well, but I threaten to. She goes out like a light. Out like a light. Now then. She lays there, cute little face and a mass of curls. And I think, how lovely. And it always reminds me of another cute little face and a mass of curls. Mr. Colin Keyes is waving with his stick. Colin had a terrible disappointment last night. Apparently his agent rang him up in the middle of the night from America and said, I've got you a movie with Mickey Rooney. And this morning, a correction. It wasn't a movie with Mickey Rooney, it was a commercial for macaroni. Big disappointment. Life's full of disappointments. You may know, I had a disappointment tonight before we came out here. Lost one of the guests for tonight's show. You may not believe this, but Bob Geldof was actually on his way to the studio when he got knocked down by a milk float. Right. Let me tell you who is on the show tonight. Some wonderful acts from Las Vegas. An act that is truly magic, the Pendragons. You will really like them. Now, the budgie has got loose from the Cambridge Theatre and has flown in here. Adam Faith is joining us. We'll be rocking all over the world. They've been rocking all over the world. They're strutting this off here tonight. Status Quo. And that man, Charlie's mate, is here. Spike Milligan, here, there and everywhere. Spike's right. And the power of love lady herself, Jennifer Rush. How's that for a nice little show? Now, Here's two young guys. We're trying to put the spotlight on the young British entertainers and comedians. Here's two guys. They are zany, got some great impressions. Will you please welcome the Brothers Demented?
They want the fish course?
Si.
Right, Manuel, what's on the fish menu?
I have a place.
Place?
Addocks.
Addocks.
Cod pieces?
Pieces of cod, Manuel.
Si. I also, Mr. Fawlty, I also have, and, Wanda.
Wanda?
Si.
A fish called Wanda? Never mind, Manuel. Let's have it now, please. Fresh chicken, Manuel! Fresh chicken! Right! It's probably my fault! And if it's my fault, I should be punished! Yes, Basil, you don't do not! Right! Germans, don't mention the war! Achtung! Achtung! Schnell! What? Where am I speaking from? Where am I speaking from? A hole underneath my nose, you twit! Manuel, bring on the cabaret!
My name is Alan Wicker. Now here this very evening, I announce my retirement from the hurly-burly world of travel. Yes, I start a brand new career, that of Wicker the Impressionist. Bobby Davro, eat your heart out. My God, forget it. My first impression of many. Listen to the voices, they're so accurate. Mr. Frank Spencer! Oh, Betty! I'm in a bit of trouble. Jessica's had a whoopsie, and I've roller skated through it.
It's a kind of magic.
Just like that. It's just like that. Today I walked into a bar. Oof! It was an iron bar! I just called to say how I love it. I just called to say how much I care. I mean, I really did. I just called to say. From to meet you, Dan's really
tremendous. It's very nice to have you two. I nearly said you two baskets. It's very nice to have you two gentlemen. Can you, I don't know anyone that does this, but could you do an impression of me?
Well, certainly not a vocal impression of you, Dan. No, but maybe a visual one.
I don't do that. Nonsense, nothing like it. Are you two the Brothers Demented? Are you really brothers? Are you?
Really brothers?
Really brothers. Which, I mean, perhaps we should have a look at you. Which is which?
I'm Paul Dez.
And I'm Derek.
Thank you, fellas. The Brothers Demented. Thank you.
Right, now, here's a group that's been rocking all around the world, and tonight, as I say, they're going to strut their stuff here. They've got a new record, and I'm sure you're going to like it. Please welcome Status Quo.
Take
Status Quo with their new single, Burning Bridges. Now, we don't often have a magic act on this show, but when we do, we have the best. And the couple you're about to see are the very best. They just won the Magic Castle Award in America, and that's their magic circle. They are tremendous. The toast of Las Vegas, and I know you're going to enjoy them. Please, they are tremendous. The Pendragons.
Barker and Stonehouse, you'll find probably the largest selection of quality furniture in the northeast and Yorkshire. Friendly, helpful staff, and probably the finest value for money anywhere. Some ideas in coordinating upholstery and fabrics. And over 35,000 square feet of beautifully displayed furniture from the world's leading manufacturers. And of course, careful, free delivery. Visit Barker and Stonehouse, the complete furniture store, Cannon Park, Middlesbrough. Somewhere out there, burglars are on the prowl. Make sure your home's secure with SOS Shutters of Substance. Roll shutters provide excellent protection against intruders, as well as insulation against cold, heat and noise. Privacy and protection for your home.
Well, I think they're marvellous, really. They kill three birds with one stone. You've got security, insulation and privacy. What more could you ask for?
Phone the operator and ask for free phone SOS Shutters. SOS.
Book your summer 89 holiday with Whiteley's Travel and Brick House and save £10 for every £100 you spend. This offer is on leading 89 holidays at Whiteley's Travel Brick House.
The new big Brook Cash and Carry is now open at Brunklick Way, Morley Leeds. Incredible opening offers on brand name products and fabulous prizes to be won. Brook Cash and Carry now open.
It's going to be a fan-dabby-dozy Christmas at the Alhambra Bradford.
With us, the Crankies and Christopher Biggins.
In Dick Whittington. Book now. Telephone Bradford 75 2000.
There's something for everyone at the Ideal Home Exhibition and Christmas Fair at the Queen's Hall, Leeds, this Friday to Sunday. An ideal Christmas show for the whole family. Nut Brown and Oxbury are giving a free stool and up to 15% discount off the normal retail price on all pianos bought before Christmas.
Northern Bathroom's biggest sale ever. Suites from only £99. Corner suites from £299. Edwardian suites from £399. Yorkshire's biggest bathroom centre, the Dark Arches, Leeds.
My guest now is a man, well, he's extraordinary. He survived a car crash, a helicopter crash, a hang gliding crash. Last year he underwent bypass operation. And he's flown here tonight, as I say, the little budgie from the Cambridge Theatre. Will you please welcome Adam Faith? Nice of you to come along. Now then, without being... Well, maybe we could be flat just for a second. The last time us two met was in the Polo Lounge. What's the name of that hotel?
Beverly Hills Hotel.
The Beverly Hills Hotel in Los Angeles. I picked up the check, as I recall. You owe me a meal. Now, we were just talking about budgie. It's a sensational success.
Yeah.
And we'll have a little yak about that in a moment. I thought I might take you back even further than a few years ago in Los Angeles to the 70s and the part that you created as budgie on TV. So why don't you have a look a little at the screen here and see, I think it was 72, wasn't it?
71, 72, yeah.
71, 72, budgie.
Best to Hurst. One against one was Hurst faces Mike England.
Oh, leave off, Hazel. I'll get you up in front of the race relations board.
I've just put your son down.
I know. And what chance has the lad have got a strike in for England in 1999 if you're going to bang him in the bed every time football comes on a box?
No chance, Budge. Like you.
I could have been some use. You know what I mean? My old man has shown a bit of interest, like what I'm trying to do, but no. My old man was just like you. Never tried to develop my natural talents.
There's one thing you have developed, Budge. It's your natural talents.
I'm talking about footer. Dirty-minded cow.
I'm talking about your son getting his afternoon rest. I'm talking about bed.
That's all you ever do talk about, isn't it? Stone me, that's all you ever think about.
Here's a bit shorter, but that's about all. That was Lynn Dolby, wasn't it?
Yeah, Lynn Dolby. His.
Of course, playing in Budgie now in the Cambridge Theatre, you've got a different girl playing Hazel. Did you choose that lady?
No, I didn't.
Anita Dobson?
Anita Dobson. Don Black chose her.
It's good chemistry, though.
It seems to work. It's been a fantastic few weeks working with her. She's great to work with.
You're doing eight shows a week.
Yeah.
What else are you doing? I know you've never got just one thing on your plate.
I haven't. I'm just about to... I'm just reorganising my financial business. I'm talking to banks at the moment. So, you know, I find myself...
When you say I'm talking to banks, I mean, I talk to them, and it's usually to put them off. What are you talking about?
Well, we're talking about merging with them. We're doing a...
Merging with banks?
Well, we're not, you know, going into business with them.
Yes. About,
with this new business of ours. And, you know, it's financial advice and corporate finance stuff.
When this man started, he didn't have an office for this financial thing. Is this true that you went to Fortnum & Mason's and had tea there every day, or just sat there and ran your business from there?
Sometimes I used to get into Fortnum & Mason's at 9 o'clock in the morning and leave at 11 at night. And they put a telephone in the corner of the restaurant for me, yeah.
And then here's the extraordinary thing. After the Fortnum & Mason thing, you go on to the Savoy and set up an office at the Savoy.
Well, the
in
Savoy,
a restaurant?
No. The Savoy asked me if I would like to become a director of the Savoy Management Company that runs the hotel. So I sit on the board of the Savoy Management Company, and we have board meetings and
discuss. But it's all quite amazing. I mean, it's a long way from Acton to the board of directors at the Savoy. I mean, there you are, 15 years of age.
Yeah, but you've come a long way.
Yeah, but I don't
deal with the banks. But I mean, from 15 years of age, Terry and Ellen in Acton, leaving school, no O-levels, nothing, right? Nothing, absolutely nothing. And suddenly Terry and Ellen is Adam Faith. How did that come about?
Well, I did, simply, when I was a kid, you know, you couldn't go and be a pop singer with a name like Terry Nellums.
Not really, no.
So Jack Good, who was the big producer at that time, and I sat in his flat one day, his wife had just had a kid, and he threw the book of kids' names at me and said, pick a name. So I just picked
one
out of women and Adam out of men. So that's how that came about.
Which came first? And obviously, you went into... Did you go into films first?
I did the singing.
Singing?
And while I was singing, I did a few films as a singer, you know, trying to act. And I realised, I wanted to be an actor, and I realised you can't do both. You had to make the break. Because to become an actor is a full-time job.
So, singer, actor, impresario, artist manager, financial advisor, what next, Chancellor of the Exchequer?
Nobody could beat Nigel. He's doing a good job on his own. Yeah, I am a fan of Nigel Lawson.
There's a lot of punters out here. Everybody these days in the shares are all having a little dip. I mean, give us... From your financial experience here, British Steel, British Water, Marks and Spencers would be a good one, because if you didn't like them, you could take them back on money and change
back.
Them.
The best investment that you can make is for an evening's entertainment. Come and see Budgie.
Isn't he a good business?
Cambridge Theatre.
Adam Faith.
It's the best night out in London.
My next guest is a man with a most inventive mind. He's the only man I know who dug a hole 300 feet down in his garden so he could be the first to get the Australian football results. A family man who loves his kids. He told me that his eldest wanted to be a nun. I said, that's a hard life. He said, I know, I've already told him. Trying to set the mood for one of the greatest and most wonderful characters, lovable characters in our business. I don't like to say the words, the one and only, it sounds corny, but in this case, there is the only one, Spike Milligan.
There's a connoisseur. It's amazing what you can get at the Finchley Labour Exchange.
Isn't it lovely to see you, my young man?
Thank you, Dave. Thank you.
Well, I just want to say you're looking fit, fine, and well. And if
I had the operation. I had it all taken away, you know. It's all in a plastic bag in the fridge. I'm keeping it there for the hot weather.
What would you do if you were sitting in this seat? And you were interviewing Spike Milligan.
What would I do?
Yes.
I'd say, why has it taken you 25 bloody years to ask me on the show?
I don't
think... The only people he hasn't on is Ronald Biggs and the Pope. And that's because they sing better than him.
I don't...
Hurry up, please. The last bus goes in an hour. Good. Where'd you get him? Thank you, Lone Clapper.
In fact, you look, I would say, attractive.
What are you doing later then?
Well, you are fitting well and obviously keeping as busy as ever.
Yes, so I wear an appliance. It's plugged into the sound system at the moment.
So what are you up to, Spike? What are you actually
I'm up to here at the moment.
Me? Well, not what up to, yes, sir. Up to. Up to 20 past nine of this.
But you've got lots of bits of things in.
Lots of bits, yes, they're in the fridge. I didn't know.
Can I take you back to the Goose?
Well, you've got a rocket or something. God, let's keep going.
I was just wondering what your favourite memory
was. I must tell you something. This is the first time I really met you for a long
time.
And I nearly met you 35 years ago. You were appearing in wintertime in a theatre in Halifax. And you were there the week before me, and I was there the week after. I remember, dreadful it was. Can't remember the name of the theatre.
Palace.
Palace. Yeah. Anyhow, I went on the Monday night, I was first actor, I looked through the curtain, and there was about seven people in. The next night it snowed, and the manager said, oh, this will kill the business. I thought I'd remind you that, yeah.
I don't need reminding of those days, but I'm still going to take you back to the Goons, because I was a fan. And looking back, where do you get the inspiration for a voice of Eccles? Was Eccles based on a real person or something from your imagination?
Yes, you would say it was Goofy in Mickey Mouse. That's what the one I used to love it. I was a kid, I used to love Goofy, and that's what I did it for. Mind you, I was living in with strange company. I mean, Sellers was a strange guy. Mm. I'll give you an example. I used to live in a flat opposite him. And Christmas week, 4 a.m, a knock came on the door. So I opened the door and Sellers is standing there stark naked with a tubi hat and an umbrella. And he says to me, do you know a good tailor?
Have you had any feedback from your friend Charles about the article in the Sunday Mail? The trainee king, as you refer to him.
No, he sent me a photograph of the tower.
Cut it out,
and a free ticket.
Listen, I get on to Spike the author. Spike, I mean, we've got another two books out, and you've written, what, 43, 44?
Yes, that's how many sold, really, 44 sold.
And you've got...
Well, these two, 40...
44, 45.
Got a room full of them.
This one's called William McGonagall Meets George Gershwin.
Yes.
I mean, that's a title. I mean...
A title.
Who the heck is William McGonagall?
Well, William McGonagall. I mean, something you might... Anybody heard of William McGonagall here?
Yes.
Great, you see. And, he basically was the world's worst poet. Give me an example of his first poem. He wrote this poem. What was he... He said, The chicken is a noble beast, the cow is much forlorner, standing in the pouring rain with a lake at every corner.
And then there's this one, which is a novel, The Loony. What's that about?
It's about 40 pages, really. Yes. With inflammation.
It's Ireland, though. It's based in Ireland, isn't it?
Yes. Well, I'm Irish by descent. I came down in a green parachute. They've done it. You did it in under 1 minute, then. Great. Story of parachutes. Lovely Irish story about an Irish pilot flying over Dublin. And his plane fails, and he jumps out, and his parachute won't open. As he's going down, he sees another Irishman coming up. As he goes past, he says to him, do you know anything about parachutes? This other bloke said, no. Do you know anything about gas stoves?
I know you like the Irish jokes, but you have a theory that the Irish in their everyday life are funnier than the jokes.
Well, I'll give you an example. My father, his mother lived in Sligo, and father used to be a farmer, and one morning the wife went to wake her husband up. She woke him up. When she went back to bring him tea, he'd gone back to sleep again. She went back and she woke him up again, and he'd had a heart attack and died. And she said, oh, Jesus, if he'd got up the first time, he'd still be alive today.
They are funny, the things they
say. Well, they're very nice people.
I love a lovely Irish story. There's Paddy and Murphy in the car. He says, Paddy, you're driving fast. He said, you think this is fast? When I'm by myself, I drive twice as fast. He says, geez, I wouldn't want to be with you when you're by yourself. It's lovely stuff, isn't it? Listen, I'm trying to write a book. I mean, one would do me about 44. You probably wrote another one while you're waiting to get on, but give me any tips, Spike. I mean, you're an author of some distinction, man.
A piece of paper's a good start.
You've tackled a lot of things, like Adam Faith on earlier, a man of many facets. But have you had any, what you would call, failures that you would accept as being failures?
Music, yes. I was a jazz musician, and I thought I was a composer. I thought, well, I'll get the music's making money. Forget jokes, money. But I wrote a lot of songs, but I always just missed writing a winner. Like I wrote, That's Why the Lady is a Trampolinist.
What's the other one? I've grown accustomed to her face flannel. The hills are alive with the sound of mucus. Oklahoma sexual. the phantom of the operation. Jesus Christ superintendent.
None of them quite made it, actually.
What that was, feelings. My teeth are full of feelings.
I can see why you left that behind, but you're very serious about your music, aren't you? Because you've got a piece that's actually going to be performed or has been performed.
Well, my mother is an Australian. She lives in Australia. And the bicentenary, I thought I'd write. My mother lives in a lovely piece of water called the Brisbane Waters, and I loved it out there. It's beautiful area. You've been out there many times. And I thought I'd write a grand waltz for Brisbane Waters for the bicentenary, and the Gosford Symphony Orchestra are going to perform it. How about this, December the 11th, in the Sydney Opera House?
Oh, that's fantastic.
How about that?
Now you. You yourself can currently be heard singing on the telephone. I mean,
well, I can't believe this.
You dial a number.
We'd like you to sing. You sure you're right about this? You know what I mean? Is it music for the deaf? You know? do you want me to do it? Do you want me to do it in Braille? I sing it in Braille. I said no. So she wants to sing any song. So I wrote a little ditty. Do you want to hear it? Yes. Say yes.
Yes, we want to hear it, don't we? Yes.
This could mean promotion for you, kid. Honestly. let me see. It's a kid song. I wrote for my kids. This is, oh, there was a little fly lived in a grocer's store, and he on the ceiling, and he on the floor, he on the bacon, and he on the jam, and he on the head of the little grocer man. The little grocer man took out his spraying gun. He said, I get that fly before the day of done. But before he could count up from 1 to 10, the little fly went on the grocer man again.
I think you should record that and stick. That could be a hit. Now, before you go, I know you're writing all the time. What have you been writing this week, maybe the last hour?
Well, I write articles for Holmes and Cards and things like that, but I make a practice of writing at least one good joke a week.
You actually sit down and write a joke?
Well, sometimes when they're bad, I stand up. And I always thought that sex is really pointless. Except for people doing it. If you're watching it, it's hysterical. All that groaning and moaning, all that steam coming off and all this ridiculous. But really, I said, sex is heartless. You know, there's no rationale. So I'll write a joke which proves that sex is really heartless. So I wrote a joke where there's a man about 75, a little shop, and he wants a very good-looking girl to go behind the counter to attract the customers. Beautiful girl turns up. Unfortunately, money starts to go missing out of the till, and he catches this girl stealing money. And he said, I'm sorry, Miss Harrison, I shall have to call the police. She said, no, don't do that. I come from a very good family. There's no alternative, Miss Harrison. He said, you've been stealing money, I'll have to call the police. She said, no, please don't do that. I would ruin my career, my family, a very good family. He said, there is an alternative. You can guess what. He said, watch it. You take me upstairs and you can make love to me. All right, if you put it like that, yes. So he went upstairs, he was 75, and he tried for about 2 hours. But nothing happened. And he said, it's no good, I'll have to call the police.
We'll be back in a couple of minutes with the Pendragons and Jennifer Rush. See you then.
If DIY is a bit of a drag, get your hands on the portable Workmate 2 system. It's the best Workmate ever. Solid as a rock. It clamps the wide and the narrow with ease. There's even an optional saw table for more work surface. The Workmate 2 system from Black & Decker. Tough tools for tough jobs.
Penguin, to the penguin. Man can't do it, just can't do it. Penguin, to the penguin. Penguin, to the penguin. The man can't do it, just can't do it. Go for the chocolate. Ha! Live for the biscuit. Penguin, penguin. The dog can't do it.
No way, can you do it? Oh.
To the penguin, to the penguin, to the penguin.
When you pick up this Christmas booklet from Argos, you'll pick up hundreds of amazing gift ideas. There are famous brand names at famous Argos low prices, and with their instant credit, you can spread the cost of Christmas. So who needs to shop around? Just pick up an Argos booklet.
It's so easy.
This is Ambrose the Cat, a wild, vicious creature, a terrifyingly uncontrollable animal. There's only one way to tame him. Ambrosia Creamed Rice. It's deliciously creamy and comes from Devon. And when Ambrose tastes it, he forgets the call of the wild. Ambrosia Creamed Rice turns this frenzied mass of claw and sinew into a sweet little pussycat. Ambrosia Creamed Rice. Devon knows how they make it so creamy.
Our Fashion Award winners, the year's most moving story.
And how to tell your kids the new facts of life.
Cliff Richard would like to share with you this, his private collection. A double album of the greatest hits from his recent career. We Don't Talk Anymore, Wired for Sound, and Some People are just a few of the songs featured in this beautifully presented collection. Share with Cliff these important memories in this his very own private collection.
Less than half the fat of any margarine. Just the thing to go with a nice bit of soul. St. Ivel Gold, because less makes more sense.
Welcome back once again, the Pendragons. They're going to perform for you now an illusion which was first created by the great Houdini. But this is their version, and I guarantee it is the fastest version anywhere in the world. Ladies and gentlemen, here with this very, very unusual illusion, the Pendragons. Sensational. Pendragon, ladies and gentlemen. Wonderful. The Pendragon. My next guest, ladies and gentlemen, is a lady who was on our show 3 years ago. The night she was here, her record was number one. We were delighted. We asked her to sing it, and that record sold a million. She's here tonight with a new single. Will you please welcome once again Jennifer Rush? That's the new single, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
What's it called?
You Are My One and Only.
I just wanted to hear you say it. Last time, she's lovely now. She's so full of confidence. It's lovely to have you here. Last time you were here, we were so
shy. I'm still a little shy.
Oh, yeah? Do you feel confident enough to do a duet with Desi?
You are the only man who I've ever dared to sing this next song with.
Let's see what happens. Put it up, Colin.
The whispers in the morning of lovers sleep and die are rolling by like thunder now. As I look
in your eyes.
And I hold on to your birthday and feel each move you make. Your voice is warm and tender, a love that I hold not for fame, 'cause I am your lady.
And I am your man. It seems I'm far away, but never wonder where I am, 'cause I am always by your side.
There's next week when he'll be meeting Julio Iglesias and Five Star. And next tonight, a mystery thriller, the nightmare story of when dreams come true.